Hello and welcome back to my YouTube channel. And in this tutorial, I want to show you how to correct this kind of an error. And the error says that the selected GPT format disk is contains a partition which is not type partition basic data grid. So how did you arrive here? Let me just quickly show you how we arrived at that particular error. So I believe this is an the amount of space that I've just shrinked from disk D. So when I want to create a new simple volume, so click next, then choose a letter G, next. If you click T, if you select that next, it'll tell you the selected GPT format. It'll throw this kind of an error. So in this tutorial, I want to show you how to go about how to correct this kind of an error. So let me just close that. At the bottom of your screen, I believe you can see the search bar. Just type in CMD. If you type in CMD, you'll see this kind of an application command prompt. Just right click on it, or just on this right side, just run as administrator, or I can just right click and run as administrator as well. Click yes, then it will open this kind of a window. So what we need to do, we are going to type in some commands. Just follow keenly. The first line of command that we're going to type in is disk part. Disk part without a space. Don't include a space. Click enter. So disk part, then the next command of line is type in list disk, list space EIS disk, not disk but disk. Click enter. Now we have this kind of a partition. It has been shown to us. So we are going to select, we're going to type in select disk zero. So the next command is to type in cell disk zero, not O but zero. So, and where is this kind of so we have whatever you're going to correct is the recovery partition, this one here, the second one. So if you type in cell disk zero, just click in enter, and it will tell you that disk zero is now selected disk. Now type in the next command, just type in list partition, list, type in list space partition, and then click enter. It will going to list all the partitions that you have in your computer, and the one that we're most interested in is the recovery one, the third partition, so partition 3. And that partition 3, if I open this computer management window, it's right here, as I believe it's the recovery partition, the second one. So that's what that's the partition that we are going to deal with, and that's where that error is originating from. So we've just typed in the list partition, and it's given us all the partitions. So the next one is to select partition 3, this one, the recovery one. So type in select partition 3. So type in select space partition space 3 and click enter, and it will tell you that partition 3 is now the selected partition. So the next one that is going to correct that kind of an error is to type in delete partition override. So that's the next line of command. Just type in delete partition override. delete. So I need to include double, so it's double R ride. That's the proper spelling of that override. So type in delete space partition space override. I believe I've typed in the correct spellings. So click enter, and it'll tell you disk partition successfully deleted. The selected partition. So just go ahead and close the command prompt or the CMD. We're going to open our computer management. So if I right click and click new simple, next. So we're going to assign to give it a new letter because I already have a disk as already assigned C. Click next. Click. I'm going to give it data. Then click next. Click finished. So now things seems correct. Now we have our disk. We have successfully corrected that error, and we have. If I open my file explorer, now I have this kind of a disk. I've successfully partitioned the correct disk, and I have a new disk right here. So that's how you go about solving that kind of an error. If you encounter one while creating a partition for your disk. So thank you guys. See you in the next tutorial.